What's going on? I am Greg Sossman, joined today by Megan Nunez of FanDuel, who's here to give her top picks for the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. What's going on, Megan?
Not a whole lot. Just trying to find some winners this week.
As always, trying to make a little bit of money. And where are we going to make money? It's going to be in Green Bay, but it's not. It's going to be with Aaron Rodgers. You like the Rams as 6.5-point underdogs here. You like a lot of dogs here this weekend. But the Rams specifically in Green Bay, we don't know who their quarterback is. We know that Aaron Donald is banged up. We know the Packers are refreshed, and you still like the Rams with the points. How come?
So, yeah, I just think this is too many points for Sean McVay in this Rams defense. Yes, I know Aaron Rodgers has been absolutely on fire, and he can make me look really stupid here. However, I just find so much value in this Rams team. You'll have Jalen Ramsey most likely covering Davante Adams, who could make him somewhat irrelevant, and Aaron Rodgers is going to have to deal with that nasty Rams pass rush. Again, I know that Aaron Rodgers could make me look stupid here and that Goff and Donald are banged up, but they're expected to play, which is huge for the Rams. But again, just so much value in catching almost a touchdown in a divisional game. So I'm going to go ahead and take the Rams plus the 6.5.
The Rams were able to stop Russ from cooking last week. Can they do the same with Aaron Rodgers this weekend? That's the question. How good is this defense? It's really good. Can the offense hang in there and just lose by less than 7 points? We'll find out this weekend. Another dog you are in on is the dog pound in Cleveland. The Browns are 10-point underdogs against the Kansas City Chiefs, but they are getting some reinforcements back in their secondary here. And I know everyone's counting the Browns out, but they're getting their coach back. Their offense obviously looked awesome against Pittsburgh. Can I hang with KC?
Okay, so I want to start off by saying I hate to bet against Kansas City. I feel like Mahomes and that offense can really have their way with whoever, wherever, however. That being said, the Browns are catching a ton of points, and it's really hard for me not to see the value just like in my first play. Just to be clear, I do not think the Browns win outright. However, their running game has been relatively stout. I think they're going to be able to get some pressure on Mahomes and make him uncomfortable. And not to mention, Baker Mayfield has always carried himself with this big game swag, and he just has a ton of moxie. And I think he's going to fall right into the role he's always wanted to be in. So, again, do I think the Browns went out right? I think that'd be an extremely long stretch. However, I do think that they're going to be able to hold on and cover that plus 10.
10 points is a large, large number for a team that just put up all those points against a really good Pittsburgh Steelers defense. The Chiefs defense isn't as stout. The Browns in offense getting back Kevin Stefanski. Nick Chubb and Kareem Hunt are healthy. We'll see what the Browns can do if they can hang in there with Patrick Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs. Go toe-to-toe with the defending champs. See what happens this weekend. All right, one favorite that you do like this weekend is the New Orleans Saints, the 3-point favorites in the Old Bowl of Tom Brady versus Drew Brees. Saints have beaten the Tampa Bay Buccaneers twice this year. You believe it happens for the third time.
I do. I'm not going to overthink this here at all. And if I'm able to throw a New Orleans pick out there, I am always happy to do so. As you said, that these two teams have already played twice this season. The first game, you could give all the excuses you want to Tom Brady since he always gets the excuses anyway. New team, new place, new coach, not enough time to gel, COVID, all that. But then fast forward to November, and they play the Saints again, and the Saints waxed them 38-3. I just personally think that the Saints have this Buccaneers team's number. I think Drew Brees knows how to play Tom Brady. I know that there's this, you know, Tom Brady redemption speaking going on. This game's going to be his redemption. I just don't see it. I like the Saints here, minus the 3 in the dome, and I'm yelling, who dat?
Who dat Nation is where you're going this week. I always happy to take the Saints, especially against Tom Brady and the Buccaneers. You're not overthinking it. The Bucs have done it twice. The third time is not the charm for Tom Brady and Bruce Arians. The Saints get it done at home in the Superdome. That's going to do it for us here. The FanDuel Hurry Up. Megan, we appreciate the time. Good luck this weekend.
Thank you. Good luck to y'all as well.
Absolutely. All right. Tomorrow on the program, Jim Sonos will join me as we go over the top DFS stacks of this divisional round. For Megan Nunez, I'm Greg Sussman. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you back here tomorrow for another edition of the FanDuel Hurry Up.